Hello friends, welcome to Insight with Glam Guru, episode 12, and today I am once again back in front of you with someone really special from the pageant industry. And today we are going to talk about one more time about a topic which is very important for you in this current situation. As you already know that people are stuck in the pandemic situation, and the pageant aspirants who are looking forward to join this year's respective Miss India pageants will have to wait for a while because the pageants are not happening, and we can certainly expect them to resume as soon as possible. But by the time, what are you doing at home? Are you preparing yourself for the upcoming Miss India pageant? What kind of preparations you are going through? And do you think that how important is it to make sure that you have all kind of preparation at the right time? And that's the reason today we are here in front of you, and we will be talking about a lot of dimensions related to the preparation for the Miss India pageant and what it takes to make yourself worthy of the title, and what all it takes to be a Miss India. But more than that, we will also be talking about, if you get a chance to represent India internationally, what is the kind of exposure, what is the experience. And today we have with ourselves someone really special who has recently only has seen this journey, has gone through with the drill and proved her mark at the international arena. And I'm going to introduce to my guest tonight without further delay. Please welcome on Insight with Glam Guru tonight, Miss Simriti Bhatija, Miss India International 2019, and she's here with us tonight, and she will be talking about a lot of things which are certainly going to help you. Hi Simriti, how are you? Simriti, we are not able to hear your audio as of now. If you can just fix it and reload it so that we can get you back. Simriti is here with us, guys, and she's just connecting with us as we are not getting the audio. But by the time I really want all of you to join this conversation. Come here and you can talk anything, you can ask her anything, because Smriti is not only a Miss India winner of last year but also has represented the country at Miss International Beauty Pageant. Those who are not much aware about Miss International Pageant, I would like to tell you, this is the third biggest pageant of the world after Miss Universe and Miss World. India as of now has not been able to get the title of Miss International, but we have performed really well there. We have a couple of first honors up, Dia Abraham in 97, Shweta Vijayashankar, second runner-up in 98, Shonali Nagrani in 2003, first runner-up, and last time when India was placed at Miss International was 2012, when Rochelle Maria Rao, who is a famous actress, a BJ, and you all must have seen her in Kapil Sharma show as well, she was the last girl to place at Miss International. But after that, Miss International is, we are still waiting as an Indians to place at that pageant, and we have had quite interesting candidates, but unfortunately none of them were able to place at the pageant. As far as Simriti is concerned, Simriti gave a very fabulous performance last year. She was very close of making it to the top 15, as we got from the sources that she's missed that spot with just a little margin. But her journey has been incredible. She has proven enough that she is worthy of the title, and she has made it very important for all of us. And also, which is the one thing which is very important, guys, here is, it's not always about to get a placement or to get the crown. The more importance is to have the journey, and that journey makes a big difference in everybody's life. And I think we again have once again back Simriti with us. Simriti, hi, how are you?
I am good, how are you?
Absolutely fine. Thank you so much for joining us tonight on Insight with Glam Guru, and we really want to have your thoughts and your experience with all of our followers. So without further delay, let me start our conversation today with you. My first question to you, Simriti, is what it takes to be a Miss India. I mean, every year thousands and thousands of girls apply. You have had a great journey. You have applied for a pageant, then you again came back, you fought for your title, and last year you were fortunate enough to get the Miss International India title, and you represented us. If you can tell our followers and the pageant aspirants what it actually takes to wear that crown which you are wearing tonight.
First of all, thank you so much for having me here. It's my absolute privilege, because whenever I have to interview about my journey and I have to talk about myself and how I came here, it actually makes me realize, it makes me feel proud of myself over and over again. And it gives me so much pleasure to share my journey, because at the same time, people are learning, girls are learning. And if I get to come on a platform like this where a lot of girls are watching me, people who actually want to get into pageants, I think nothing like it. So I think you guys are doing a great job by doing that. About my journey, honestly, it has been a roller coaster ride. It's not easy, you know. It is very difficult to be where I am today, because people see all the sparkles, but behind that, it's a lot of effort, a lot of blood and sweat that takes. You know, it's a lot of investment that goes behind it. So it was quite a journey for me, because it started in 2017 when I had literally no experience of pageants. I don't even know what pageants were, to be very honest. I always just know that, you know, my family and my relatives used to tell me, you know, you'll become Miss World someday, you'll become Miss India someday, you know. So I used to be like, it used to make me happy, but I did not think about it. Because this is something that I do. I don't necessarily plan things. What I do is I always keep on grabbing things that come my way and, you know, do it with full determination. And, you know, it's very important to know when is the right time to grab opportunity, right? Yes. So that's what I did. 2017, I opted for a pageant named Miss Mumbai 2017. And I won the pageant without any training. I was raw. I did not know how to walk, talk, anything, you know. So after 2017, actual journey began, because that's when I gained confidence. When I used to talk, people think that I was always this confident in talking in front of the camera, you know, or on the stage, but I was not. I was a person, I could dance, I could sports, swim, etc., but I couldn't speak. I used to hesitate going on the stage and speaking. So I developed this personality of mine where I have to become that confident. So it's a total misconception. I have evolved in the person I am today. It's a very slow process.
To interrupt you here, and we definitely would listen a lot about you now. But if you can tell us one by one, what kind of preparation is needed if somebody is looking forward to represent India or to make it at the Miss India pageant? What are the primary basic things which they really need to work upon?
See, there are a lot of things that you have to work upon, considering there are things that are very practical and there are things that are professional. So when we talk about professional things, it comes walk, your how you dress, your talking, your Q&A, all this is a professional space, because this is something that you have, that the pageant demands, you know. It is directly telling you that, okay, we are going to question you, we are going to see your talk, and we are going to see your walk. But there are certain things that a pageant won't come and tell you that, okay, we are going to judge you on this basis. But these are certain things that you have to develop inside yourself. That is your personality, your confidence. You know, even if you answer something wrong, or you don't know the answer, you fumble, but you are confident and you pick that situation up, I think you are a winner. So confidence, you have to take care of yourself, your skin, your body. You have to reflect your aura. People, you know, don't understand this, but I am a true believer of meditation. Like, you know, I meditate. I'm a little spiritual person. So I feel that when there are thousands of girls, and, you know, when we go for auditions, state auditions, there are thousands of girls that come for audition. How do you stand out from so many other girls? So I practice certain...
One more point, is very important, because I really want to add on to what you were saying. You know, girls from small towns are coming. We are having, you know, winners from Lucknow, our city, you know, Vartika Singh, Pankhuri Gidwani from Patna, Supriya Amin, your predecessor who represented us already at Miss International. We had Priyanka Kumari, and, you know, these girls are coming from small towns, but these girls are always quite confused whether I will make it or not, and they always feel like, you know, I will fall short in front of a girl from Mumbai or Delhi or someone, because now the NRI girls are also coming in and they are getting the spots, and they are, since very well groomed, they have a great educational background as well. How what do you think about it? Is it actually there is something to say, big city or small city or NRI, or do you think at the final level all are just on the same platform, or what are the obstacles which really the girls need to work upon?
So I'll tell you something, it's not just about a girl coming from Patna or Bihar or from Bombay. There are specific places in Bombay, small towns that you don't even know the name of. Okay, there are also talents, even if they are called that they are from Bombay, but they come from a small town. Okay, I'll tell you something, I come from a small town. Where I was born, I don't think you wouldn't even know the name of that place. Now I stay in Bombay. I have grown and I'm a Sindhi. So when you consider a Sindhi background, Sindhi people are not that open with pageants and you going out and doing modeling. I have fought for my space. Touch wood, I am very lucky because I have such kind of parents. They've helped me. They did not stop me. They knew that I'm going to do this, what I'm good at. So, this is a very big misconception where girls think we come from a small background and, we are from a small city. It doesn't matter. That's the reason I was saying there are certain practical things that only you can do it. Keep the professional aside that, I understand sometimes people don't have enough money to spend for training purposes. So that is a totally different topic. But what I am saying is something practical that you have in your own hands. Now I can I can sit in front of my mirror and start talking to myself and develop the confidence of speaking. And if I am sitting at home, I can go through some good makeup tutorials and start, experimenting on my face, what looks better, what looks good, what doesn't suit me. I can work out. These are certain things to build up my confidence. These are certain things that I have in my own hands and I can do it. This is not nobody or no small city. Nothing can stop me.
I wanted to know here that too. Have you ever thought of being a Miss India? I mean, what was your primary plan, or you have prioritized? How did you prioritize your studies, your priorities as your career, and how to plan it? Because the girls are quite confused. Should I join this year, or at what is an ideal age? Should I complete my studies first? What should be the way of looking at if you are looking to participate in pageant like Miss India?
See, there is no specific age. As you know, that Miss India has a specific criteria that you can only participate in so-and-so age. Okay? So, it's not specific that you have to go in when you're 18 years old, or when you're 20 year old, you're 23 year old. You have to take your own time when you have the self-realization that, I can do this and I'm ready for it. I had that realization when I was 18 because it was too early and I already knew that I have to do this. So good for me, I went in early and I started off early. So I tried for myself. So the earlier you try, the better, because what happens is it's not necessary that you will go and in the first take you will be selected and you will win. That's what happened with me. When I was 18, I tried for Miss India, didn't work out. 19, didn't work out. 20, I tried and it worked out. So, this is how you do it. If you start in your, age that is almost, the verge of, whatever the criteria of the pageant is, then you don't have much chances. That's the only criteria that you can follow. Otherwise, I think that there is no specific time. You can start even today to start and build yourself to become confident. I take up workshops for pageants. I always tell girls that, you don't prepare yourself for a pageant, it doesn't define you. You prepare yourself for life. You have to be confident, not for a pageant, but for your life. And once you start living your life that way, then ultimately everything that is that you are worth it, you deserve, you get it automatically.
I want to really add on to one thing which is very relevant here is, do you think that Miss India in the past couple of years has transformed, from a brand identity to something which has become more desirable for girls? But do you actually see that Miss India is giving winners like you a platform or a exposure which is required? I mean, if you compare your year with maybe 10 years back when Nicole Faria was Miss Earth, or maybe going back more like when Lara Priyanka, they all were international winners, or maybe Miss India, in fact just Miss India not being an international winner as well, do you think it has changed in the past couple of years and people's and the approach of general public towards Miss India has changed, and do you think we really need to work on that?
It has definitely changed. You know, there are certain things that have, they have a positive side to it, a change, yes. A positive change, while there are also some negative things. Because negative, to be a few, I've seen girls desire, yes, the title so much that when they don't get selected, they get crazy, you know. They feel that they've lost the purpose of their life. They feel, yes, that they are not good enough. They feel, honestly, when I was rejected for continuously 2 years, even there was a slight, little bit of, shaking confidence that, yes, you know, that it happens. It's a natural human tendency. But yes, I picked up myself and I knew that, you know what, this is not something that is going to push me back. So there, yes, I have seen girls, they are heartbroken. They feel that, oh my God, I'm not getting selected. I'm not good enough. So just one thing, girls, everybody is watching today. I just want to tell you one thing. Yes. You go to a pageant, you are just the people. You have to go and give your best. You don't have anything in your hands. If you don't get selected, that is not in your hands. It's a part and parcel of a competition. When you go in a competition, yes, you go with positivity, but you can't let someone else decide if you are good enough or not. You are going, think about it as a competition, that I'm going, I will give my best, I will learn.
That's a very valid point, that one has, yes, to be persistent. Their approach,
exactly. You have to be ready for failures. You have, yes, to be ready for rejections. It's a part, yes, and parcel of pageants. You have to, yes, have to train yourself that, okay, if I go there, I get rejected, I am not going to think that my life is over, you know.
And I think there are so many examples also, Simrithi, in front of us. I mean, universally, at the universe level, if I talk about Pia Alonso, what's back, who has been, you know, idolized by so many girls. She's tried for Miss Philippines for 3 years, and then only she was able to get the main title. She represented, yes, her country. And guess what? She became Miss Universe. So, I mean, you are really putting it right way, that it's about a persistent effort.
Exactly.
You don't have to, and you have to believe in yourself as
believe in
everyone.
Yourself and don't, you know, don't put yourself down saying that, oh, I did not get selected. See, you are doing your job. The judges are doing their job. They have
their
to select
job,
in a bunch of people. So you, yes, don't have to become negative. All you can do, yes, is, you know, keep trying. And if you are at a point where you feel that, you know what, ab bahut ho gaya, I don't think I can try more.
Absolutely.
Take a step back. Realize what your goals in your life are, what you are good at, and choose,
yes,
another path. You know, not everybody has to walk in the same direction.
Yes,
there are so many options in the world today. That
I think that's what you all have proved in your respective lives, because everybody is not going for Bollywood. There are so many exposures right now, and you all are utilizing,
exactly,
that opportunity.
Exactly.
Now, I would really like,
exactly,
to talk about something very important, because I really want all the girls and all the followers who has, you know, a quintessential approach about pageants, it's just about glitz and glamour, to know about what actually takes to be a Miss India. And now I'm going to talk about your journey at Miss International. I mean, it's a pageant which Indians are really waiting to see a winner. You tried your best. Last year, you came very close of placing. But I would like to ask you first, experience. What is your experience at Miss International in terms of a candidate? I mean, what kind of response you got from the respective organizers, co-contestants, national directors, and what image or what position India is currently having at Miss International, if you can tell our viewers quickly about it.
So, honestly, India is a very respectful country when you go outside, okay? People respect you for, you know, so much, you know, India is known for cultures and diversity and ethnicity and so much more, your values, you know. When I was there, I thought that, you know, I could see my values, that, you know, I have learned so much. And when I was there, I felt so proud to be an Indian, because, you know, these are the values that only we learn. I don't think a lot of people even know about it in different countries. So people, honestly, wherever we used to go, people used to see India on my sash, and they used to be like, India, you know. So I used to feel very happy as a candidate. I worked really hard to make a mark, and it depends on certain pageants. You know, if you go in Miss International, they have a different approach of India, and if you go in this world, there is a different approach of India. So overall, India was given a lot of respect. I was given a lot of respect, and as a candidate, I really felt that I was so, you know, I was really proud of myself, because India was pushed everywhere where they had to, you know, give a speech or they wanted a girl to talk, because they knew that Indian girls can talk so well. And I think that, you know, we have to, it's high time that we realize that, that, you know, consider all the beautiful, beautiful girls from all over the country, get them on one stage, and you will see the difference that Indian girls can talk so well. They have a mind that is full of cultures. At the same time, they also know a practical space of the world, so they can combine it and think it that way. So India,
yes, you put it very well, and I really want to quickly take some questions, because you know, we are running out of time, man. We really want to utilize the opportunity to the fullest with you tonight. Let's start one by one. We have Kritika Abhishek, and she's saying, Simrithi, you look beautiful today. Love from your fan. She's congratulating you.
Thank you.
She's also asking you that, can you suggest some, you know, quick tips to have a glowing skin like you? She's very well impressed with your skin, and she wants to.
Okay, thank you so much. What was the name you said again?
Kritika.
Okay, thank you so much, Kritika. I love when my fans talk to me like this. Thank you so much. So, for your skin, first and very basic thing, have lots and water. Lots and lots of water. Basic thing, literally, I have a water bottle every minute with me, you know. I have my water bottle and I just keep drinking it.
Yes.
Drink lots of hot water. It really, really helps.
Yes.
I'm giving you some tips and tricks that is very easy. You don't need to spend anything. Try doing lots and lots of cardio, because the more you sweat, the more your skin, you know, your pores open, and you know, you have that, you know, all the organisms, you know, they start working. So make sure that you sweat, you know. And the major thing is, please consult your dermat. Because what kind of, you know, skin type you have, he knows it better, he or she knows it better. They will guide you. When you use any makeup product, make sure that you see the ingredients. It should be tested properly. If it doesn't suit you, just let it out. So these few basic things that you can follow, that's it. That's
absolutely. I think very nice. Let's take some more questions. We have Sunita Mishra. I think she's saying, explain everything so beautifully. She is saying you're so pretty once again. We have now Nishant Shashi Kumar, and he is saying that you speak with so positivity. Again, he's admiring you, and he's also commenting that listening to you now, it is hard to believe that you missed the cut at Miss International. I mean, he believed that, you know, how
thank
could you not
so much.
Is supporting you once again. We have Aparnika also. She's saying we are proud of you, and there we have some of the comments from our followers who are really appreciating your conversation tonight. Now, Smriti, I'm going to ask you something very important once again in terms of, you know, what it takes to be a top-notch contender. I mean, every year we have so many girls coming in. Last year was quite a decent year for India. Suman Rao made it to the second runner-up at Miss World. You gave a very phenomenal performance. Tejaswini Manogana, although also she couldn't make it, but she was very much there. She was so much supported by the fans. And at Miss Universe also, Vartika Singh placing after 4 years, you know, for India, and quite a relief for all of us to have that once again back. What can you talk about the kind of competition level is existing right now? I mean, we have the Philippines, who is the powerhouse of beauty, Venezuela, the old veteran country. I mean, it's so hard to beat. And now new companion, you know, countries coming in, Vietnam, Thailand, Cambodia, our neighbor, Nepal, they are so prepared. And Latin America is always there. And, you know, so what can you talk about the competition level right now at different respective pageants, and how the candidate needs to prepare right now only before even making to Miss India?
So I'll tell you, the competition has increased to an extent that when you go in the pageant, you will not be able to judge that, oh my God, you know, you'll see the countries and you'll be like, I haven't even heard the name of the country, but the girl is fabulous. Yes. So even the small countries, they are working so hard behind their girl. They have come to a realization that, okay, you know, we have to, the main concentration here is to choose a winner and to prepare her to the fullest. So I think that what a person that has to apply for Miss India has to know that when you go for a pageant, you have to not only think that you are gonna go and prepare yourself to win the title of Miss India, you have to go as a prepared contender to be in an international pageant. For instance, me, when I was going for Glamman Supermodel, I swear I had not prepared anything, what pageant, I don't know anything. All I was seeing was Miss International. I was everything that I did during my even my national pageant was keeping my mind that, okay, I have to go international, and I was prepared for international. So, you know, even then, because what happened was when I won the title, I just had 1 month, and that 1 month I did not have to do everything in that 1 month, because I was already preparing for Miss International. I had already had my preparation. So then I was okay, you know, this is what I was prepared for. So this is the main thing, that when you go for a pageant, take a very good approach that you are not going to win the title of the Miss India title. You are going directly to the international pageant. What happens is it saves time, because from the beginning you are pushing yourself to an extent that you are going for a bigger pageant. And
I think also add on to your value, because you are targeting the international pageant and you are already on another level. I mean,
because there are so many pageants, and different pageants have different criteria for a girl. For example, a girl that goes for Miss World has to be, you know, sweet and has to work for beauty with purpose. At the same time, Miss Universe has to be confident, bold, you know, just she can talk so well, walk so well. At the same time, Miss International is a very bubbly looking girl, you know, pretty face, smiling. So that's what I want you to know, is when you go for a national pageant, the judges see you, and then and if you act like a girl that is suitable for a Miss International pageant, they will obviously pick you. You know, why will they not pick you?
Is it necessary to be like something? I mean, do you have to follow protocol? Miss International
It's not a protocol. See,
are actually not able to identify what they have to do, and in that journey, they are losing their own charm.
Exactly. See, all you don't have to follow a protocol. What you have to do is you have to decide what pageant you're going. Now, for example, if you're going for Miss Universe, you have to prepare yourself in a way that Miss Universe girls are. Watch Lara Dutta, watch Sushmita Sen, watch these Miss Universe girls, you know, they are confident, they have an amazing body, their walk is so strong. At the same time, if you see Miss World majorly focuses on beauty with purpose. If you are planning for Miss World, make sure that you start working on your beauty with purpose project right now. These are the things that I'm telling you, that when you go in your national pageant, people see, you know, the judges see, you know, she's been doing her beauty with purpose for a year, and she can be a very good contender for Miss World.
That's a really nice point, because it will give you an extra edge over the other.
Exactly.
Also, if you start preparing, targeting your international pageant or the ultimate stage you want to be, automatically will reflect. I'm going to quickly take one more question, Simrithi, because we are running out of time, and I really want to take this question for you. We have Bibek Ray Chaudhary, and he's asking, hi Simrithi, you're extremely pretty and wanted to ask you something that Miss International organization views about India. Are we really treated as a weak or a non-threatening sash there? What is the status of India? Because of course people have this query, because we both had Miss World, we got Miss World, we got runner-up, Miss Universe also quite a decent thing, but you know, when it comes to international, what he's asking, and I really want to ask you as well, is it India international?
I'll tell you something. India is a country where in international pageants, when you go, people look up to you, okay? When you go in the international pageant, people fear India. It's not a, you know, it's not an easy target. India is very strong. Believe me, when I was there, I used to see people feel that, okay, she can be my competitor. And, you know, I don't know what goes behind the pageant. Maybe they try to push India back. Or I don't know that, because we never get to know that. All I can say is that when I went there, you know, I was respected, you know. I could see that people, girls feel that I am their competition. And honestly, I shouldn't be saying this, but I was confident, not just me. I think the whole pageant was confident that if I made it to top 15, I will make it till top 5. Because
once you want to add on to one thing, because most of the followers must not be aware about it, that you were actually the top 15 picks of most of the pageant followers by from, I don't want to name any pageant particular forum, but I can surely say that, you know, you were leading them.
In fact, when I did not even win. When I did not win, I did not get into top 15. There were so many YouTube pages and pageant pages telling that, you know, these are the girls that had, that deserved to be in top 15 but weren't there. So they were shocked.
Absolutely. And that's what I really want to say, that, you know, you and I can tell this, you know, today very frankly, that I also believe that after Rochelle Maria Rao, you are the only Miss India International, I personally feel that, you know, who has really made it a very huge impact for India at Miss International. And I'm very sure that next year, whosoever is going to represent us will definitely have a big to follow, because it's not, again we are saying, it's not about the placement of the crown, but it's about what difference you made. And that difference, you have, I think, has started in favor of India. And last year, I think people are definitely once again going to take India as a threat national. Now, since we are running out of time, Smriti, I want to ask you my last question, I believe, but I really don't want to. Can we see Smriti Bhatija coming back to the pageant arena once again, trying hard, or maybe representing India at a bigger pageant, maybe at Miss Universe or Miss World? Do you have any plans of coming back to the industry?
Honestly, I people always tell me that I'm a Miss Universe material, and honestly, I feel myself, because the way I talk, the way I walk, I feel that I can have so much to, you know, to give. I have so much to give in the Miss Universe pageant. If I go there, I know how to, just feel inside your veins that.
I just heard it that you're also saying, any plans for giving pageant another shot?
Yeah, so I really don't know if I am, but I would really want to if it is Miss Universe, because that pageant, as I say, you know, you have this thing called instinct, and have this instinct in myself that if I go to the platform of Miss Universe, I think I can do great. I don't know why, I just feel, you know, that intuition that I have. I have.
Absolutely, and I think that's a very well thing put together by you, Smriti, that she is talking to us right now, and she is saying that, you know, she will like to take this opportunity once again back in life, and if there is time, and they say, yes, Smriti, carry on, you were missed slightly.
So if I get an opportunity to represent India in the Miss Universe, love to, and I will give my all to it, because that is something that I would really, really, it's in my forte. I know how to handle it.
Absolutely,
but as of now, I'm also doing my other things. I'm focusing on my career, my auditions, my acting skills, you know. So I don't know, with time, as I said, that I don't plan things in my life. If I get the opportunity, if I feel that this is the moment, I have to grab the opportunity, I will definitely grab it.
Absolutely. I
so
think
I'm
it's
just
a very,
waiting for that moment.
Yes, I really want to say congratulate you for this, because you have time also. I mean, you are so young, so confident at this age. You already have represented at Miss International, the third biggest pageant, and it just need some more time for you to prepare mentally. And I think, you know, when we can have Namrata Shirodkar back in 93 being a Miss India Universe, and at the same time going for Miss Asia Pacific, we can have Vartika Singh. Last year she was Miss Grand International, second runner up, and then she came back and represented us for Miss Universe. And we are also getting to know that Meenakshi Chaudhary could come back, and you know, so many good girls and you know, talent like you are really passionate about this. So we definitely would like to see you once again, and we give you our all the wishes, and we really hope that you will make one day to the Universe stage, and again will wear the sash of India, and you know, represent us beautifully. Thank you
Absolutely.
So much, Simriti
Thank
Bhakar.
You so much for having me. Thank you so much, all the audience that have been looking at us. And thank you so much for all the love you guys have given me. It's unbelievable, honestly. Keep giving me such love. And also, one more thing, last thing. I take up workshops for pageants.
Yes.
And whoever, you know, girls that are interested in working, you know, hard with me for pageants that they are preparing, they can always contact me on my Instagram. If you want, my Instagram ID is Simriti Bhatija. You can go check it out and DM me if you want. I would really love to help you guys with my, you know, journey and with my experience. I would like to train you guys, whoever wants to go in the back.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that's very good because, you know, we had a time when the girls like you or, you know, Madhu Sapre went for Miss Universe hardly 10 or 15 days before. They were don't know what to do. But now the time has changed. And we have, you know, veterans like you who can really, you know, talk about it and can really give these girls a lot of exposure and a lot of learning. So definitely people and the girls specifically who really want to make it big can definitely follow her journey and contact her. And thank you so much, Simriti, once again for joining us on Inside the Glam Guru. It was a pleasure talking to you and we really wish you all the best for your future, you know, upcomings. And we also wish you luck that you will come back again and we will see you soon at the Miss Universe stage. Thank you very
much. Thank you.
So that was, guys, Simriti Bhatija, Miss India International 2019, joining us live on Insight with Glam Guru. She talked a lot about her journey, the pageant, you know, what the Miss International is looking for, and give a lot of tips to all the young girls out there who look forward to these candidates. You can prepare yourself with all the feedbacks and suggestions given by Simriti tonight. Thanks for joining us, guys, on Insight with Glam Guru. We'll keep coming back to you. You can follow our page once again. As I always say, follow us on Facebook at @GLAMGURUU. We are also there on YouTube at Glam Guru, and now we are also exposed to international audiences with our Insta page, that is @iGlamGuru. Do check them out and we'll keep coming back to you. Do watch our Glam Guru talk next week, and of course Insight on the weekend next week. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and thank you so much for joining us on Insight with Glam Guru. Have a great night. Thank you.